Hi, everyone. Welcome to Kind of New. I'm Colleen Cosmo Murphy, the founder of Classic Album Sundays. And Classic Album Sundays is the world's most popular album listening session, and our website is filled with information about classic albums, so you should check it out. This is a series we've been doing with the Jazz Cafe now for a couple of years called Kind of New, in which bands play classic albums live. And coming up next month on February 18th, we have Snazback performing Curtis Mayfield's 1972 classic album, Superfly, so you might want to check that out. And also in this series, there's going to be a band covering Pet Sounds by Beach Boys. And that'll be quite interesting, because if you are a Beach Boys fan, you'll know how dense some of that production is, that Brian Wilson spent so much time making that album. Which kind of brings me to Endtroducing, because of course, Endtroducing itself is also very dense. And it's the debut album by Californian producer and DJ Josh Davis, aka DJ Shadow. And the name of the album evokes the end of one thing and in the introduction of something new. And that's exactly what this album really did, because when it came out in 1996, it was a unique collage of music, old music, and it really had no precedent. It was almost entirely based on samples from Shadow's vast vinyl record collection. Samples from funk, psychedelia, jazz, hip-hop, rock, ambient. And it entered the Guinness Book of World Records as the first album solely constructed from other pieces of music. But this wasn't really a gimmick. I mean, it was built entirely from the heart, because Josh's passion for hip-hop culture was immense, as was his vinyl record collection and his eclectic musical taste. He was influenced by the electro and hip-hop producers that pushed the cut-and-paste culture to its limits. Producers like Steinsky, Curtis Mantronix, Prince Paul, and the Dust Brothers. But Endtroducing really pushed it into a different dimension. DJ Shadow once said, "The way that I make music is take what's around you and subvert it into something that's 100% you, but also has a cultural connection and the way that it was done before." Tonight we'll witness a live recreation of this instrumental hip-hop masterpiece. The band is led by producer, composer, and bassist Ben Marc. And he's worked with musicians like China Moses, Matthew Herbert, Shabaka, Jose James, and Dizzy Rascal. He released his own single, Wait, in 2016. He has an album coming out sometime this year. And his song, The Mighty, was recently featured in Ashley Henry's debut album. Please give a warm welcome to Ben Marc.
There's a microphone.
You got it. So you excited for tonight?
So excited.
Oh, good. We're excited to hear it too, because it's going to be such an interesting, you know, reimagining of this classic album.
Indeed.
So tell us, how did you first discover Endtroducing?
Endtroducing was a big part of my HMV world when I worked in HMV for many years.
I was a former record store employee too. That's where you learn about music, you know?
Yeah. But I was in the classical section, so I was always hanging out with people listening to classical music. Mozart, Brahms. Upstairs, I don't know if anyone's been to the Trocadero back in the day. That was massive, right? It's massive. So I was upstairs on the third floor. All the hip-hop kids were downstairs, like, going through all the records, and really annoyed that I wasn't there.
Why were you in the classical department?
Just being a classical head as well. Just studying at Trinity College of Music, double bass, with an amazing teacher called Chichi Nwanaku, who has an orchestra called Chinika. She's incredible. So I was so in that world, and then I ended up downstairs at some points, and that was a massive album that was being sold in 96.
And so what was it about it that appealed to you when you first heard it?
I think just how much people were just listening to it. And I think, obviously, the music is incredible, but it brought so much different type of people together.
I mean, were you a hip-hop fan at that time?
Totally.
And so who were you listening to at that time?
At that time, it was certainly a lot of Biggie Smalls, that world, Jay-Z, Wu-Tang, that kind of world. So not really, I mean, Dr. Dre was sampling and all that in that world. But yeah, it really changed the game.
It really did. Yeah. Do you think, I mean, the fact that it had no lyrics, I mean, except for a few little vocal samples here and there, maybe a little bit of lyrics, yeah. But and it was kind of more, do you feel it was more cinematic in a sense, that it really stood out in that kind of a way?
100%. And just coming from the classical world, that really got to me. It really got to me, as opposed to just, here's the A section, and then there's a B section, and then there was this section. And no, this was a story being told with art. It was amazing.
Yeah. Yep. Well, I like to hear kind of hip-hop played live, and I don't know if anyone has heard of Sly Fifth Avenue, this tribute to Dr. Dre. So good. It's such a fantastic album. I absolutely love it. So I'm really excited to hear what you're going to do tonight, because what are the challenges of a live recreation of an album that's solely made up of samples?
A simple question, actually. Simple answer, I should say.
Is that a simple question, then?
I'm sorry. But it is an easy answer to say, because we're all jazz musicians. I haven't brought any production world. I haven't brought any sampling machines. We're all going to play live, and we're all going to improvise, and we're all going to take it apart. And yeah.
So you guys are just such great players. You can do anything.
I think so. I've got an amazing band. The band is killing.
Who is playing with you tonight? That's a good time to introduce them.
Yeah. On drums we have Questy Navorian. Quizzy in the house, big up. We have Bobby Quingley on guitar. We have Deschanel Gordon on piano and Marcus Joseph on saxophone and et cetera, et cetera. Yeah.
Now, when you obviously had to listen to this album over and over, because I don't think there was any kind of sheet music or anything to kind of play this. Were there any, as it is so dense, did you make any new discoveries as you were listening to this album?
Yeah, I mean, during the rehearsal, it was quite insane, actually, because I would chart out the songs for the guys, and I thought I did a great job. But then, the keyboardist or whoever's on another harmony instrument will express that there's an F sharp minor chord over this B major chord, and I'm like, I don't hear that. So I think everyone had their own idea of harmony and how dense it is, and how you move from one section to another. We collaborated on getting what we think the hooks are, I guess, and the main part of the songs.
And were there any parts that were particularly difficult to play and to figure out?
Nope.
No, it's all easy. All the breeze. That's
no, there's so one. There was I think Changeling. How do you say that? Changeling. Changeling. That's a tough tune.
Now, the thing that's interesting about this album is there's samples from all over the place. Björk, Meredith Monk, Marlena Shaw, Metallica, Nirvana, I believe, Tangerine Dream. Were there any samples of records where the old record itself kind of had a feeling of nostalgia or a real personal connection for you?
Great question. Not really. Sorry.
So it's just more the album itself that has the nostalgia.
It's not. I'm not really here to pick out the little things like that. I think I'm hearing the bigger story and how he went from a 7/4 groove to a 4/4 groove, and how did that harmony change from there to there, as opposed to that's his job. He's done that. I am a crate digger. I love listening to records, but. Yeah, it's just different ears. And then maybe one day I'll get into that and take it apart. I know someone else has done that, but yeah.
Do you think Shadow is not only a producer, but in a sense a musician?
He plays drums, right? Does he play drums?
He's a drummer. He programs beats. Yeah.
But yeah, I think he plays. I think he's an amazing drummer.
I mean, with this album itself, like is constructing stuff from samples and putting it all together and arranging it. Is it just a production job or is it also a musician job?
I think it's a bit of both. It's art, and how you describe art. And he's an amazing producer and musician, and his latest stuff now is working with Nas and all of these heavy MCs. So he's, he wouldn't be there if he wasn't
up to scratch.
Up to scratch. Yeah.
And what are some of your favorite songs to play on this record?
All of them, but especially Changeling. Especially
Why is that?
Because it's difficult, and I think we mastered it. I think we got there. I think we're going to take it to another space.
I think the audience will be the judge of that, huh?
Indeed.
Any other songs that you love to play from this record?
I think all of them. They're amazing.
Now, when this album came out in 1996, it really inspired a lot of other bands, even bands like Radiohead, who really were inspired for their next, for their LP, OK Computer. Where do you hear the legacy of this album?
Everywhere, to be fair. I think everyone is sampling lots of things all the time. You could have a clap sample, you can have and he's introduced that space of creativity for people. Obviously, there's people like Dilla and Forte, and this goes on, doesn't it? Brain has gone.
Dilla and Forte are great examples.
Yeah. So I think there's it happens with every genre. Every musician will think about taking taking stuff from people. Transcribing. Well, I think transcribing is a really good thing in music as well.
Why is that?
You learn the history and then you move on.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're excited for you to give a new history to this album in a few minutes' time. Thank you so much, and good luck.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Give it up for Ben Marc.
Thank you. Thank you. Love, love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift. Close your eyes and look within. Love yourself, you can win. You can be do anything, it's true, yo. So live the life that you love. Love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift. Close your eyes and look within. Love yourself so you can win. You can be do have anything, it's true, yo. Everything is everything. I'm on my bike pedaling, trying to get this cheddar in. I want to be on top of it, because life's not just Monopoly. I'm working out properly in the gym daily. Nothing's gonna stop me. Marcus Joseph, I'm so flipping hungry. I want it all. I want to be the best G. I'm standing tall. I'm living life stress free. Even when I pull, I see it as a test to me. So live the life that you love. Love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift. Close your eyes and look within. Look within. You can be, do, have anything if you live the life that you love. Love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift. Close your eyes and look within. Love your soul so you can win. You can be, do, have anything. It's true. Elevate, meditate, love yourself every day. Read a book, do some stuff that gets your mind in a state. Stay awake, celebrate, love the life you have today. Cause you could be here today, gone the next, but no mistake. Trust the soul and watch the road, pass it on and it will show. All people around the globe come together, life is precious. I'm spitting truth in your eardrum, cause the kingdom of God is within you, son. So live the life that you love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift, close your eyes and look within. Love your soul so you can win, you can be, do, have anything if you live the life that you love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift, close your eyes and look within. Love your soul so you can win, you can be, do, have anything. It's true, yo. Take him to church, yo. Take him to church, yo. Take him to church, yeah. Yo, love the life that you live. Love the life that you live. Live the life that you love. Say life, love, love. When I say love, you say life, love, love. Hey, when I say love, you say life, love. When I say love, you say life, love. Live the life that you love the life that you live. Remember that life is a gift. Close your eyes and look within. Close your eyes and look within. You can be, do, have anything if you love the life that you live the life that you love. Remember that life is a gift, close your eyes and look within. You can be, do, have anything. It's true, it's true, it's true. Hey, Ben Marc.
Thank you. That's what I meant to say. Thank you.
Thank you. All good? You good?
Thank you.
We've got a special, really honored to have this person come join us to sing these last two tunes. Her name is Roba. Let me tell you this, man. Her name is Roba. She's from Attica Blues. Who knows Attica Blues? Who remembers Attica Blues? Then everyone must know. Roba, please.
Good evening, everyone.
Oh,
Can we hear it for Ben Marc, please? Kwesi on drums. Bobby Q on guitar. Marcus Joseph on sax and MC. Deschanel on keys. And of course for DJ Shadow.
Thank you. che perdiamo tanto tempo fa. C'era già quella rosa che ti ho dato, che canzone che ho cantato a presenza.
Give it up. Deschanel on keys. Man like. Marcus Joseph on all saxophones. We got Bobby Q on guitars. Kwesi Y. And Robber.
Oh, and Ben Marc!
We're Ben Marc. We've loved it. We want to come back. We want to do some more. Thanks for coming. Support the night. Thank you so much.